You're listening to In Our Headphones.
Your chance to discover the songs KEXP DJs don't want you to miss. I'm Janice Headley.
And I'm Isabel Khalili. And this is your never-ending source for new music discovery from listener-powered KEXP. Hey, this is Isabel. And for this episode, I'm joined by DJ Miss Ashley. But before we get into her song choices, I want to address you. As you may know, we launched this podcast a couple months ago as an evolution of our Song of the Day podcast, which had been running for close to 20 years, and simply delivered one full song each day with no hosts, no talking. We understand that moving to this talk-based format is a big change, and it's not for everyone. But if you're listening and you have been enjoying this new series and how it brings you context about the music straight from KEXP DJs, we'd love to hear from you. So if you could take a moment right now or after listening to this episode to leave a positive review, tell us what you like about In Our Headphones, that would mean a lot to us. You can do this on Apple Podcasts, or if you're listening somewhere else with an option for ratings and reviews, you can do it there. And as always, you can write feedback to us directly at headphones@kexp.org. Okay, I think that's enough preamble for today, but I want to get into my conversation with Ashley, the DJ, producer, and my good friend. Ashley, thank you for being here with me today.
Thank you for the invite. I'm stoked to be here.
I noticed you're coming up on 15 years as a DJ at KEXP, which is wild. Did you always think that this would be a career for you?
Never thought it would be, actually. when I originally started as an intern at KEXP, I had my mind set on production. I wanted to work behind the scenes. I've always been kind of a shy person, so I never imagined I'd be in front of a microphone. And it's just kind of the way the winds blew, honestly, that I ended up as a DJ here, among other things.
Yep. Can you talk about some of those different roles you have?
Yeah. I'm very happy to be part of 90.teen. I'm now the program coordinator for 90.teen and the lead instructor, so teaching young people how to be a broadcast DJ at KEXP.
Wow. What have you learned from that experience?
So much. I'm constantly learning from that experience. I think my favorite thing about it is just hearing the perspective of these young people, especially by way of the music that they choose, and learning about, you know, how they discovered KEXP, why they're so passionate about music. And it just so often comes back to this radio station.
Really? Like
the young people in this current cohort pretty much just grew up with KEXP on in their household. So they know nothing else. Like, it wasn't like they went and discovered it one day. It's like, it's just always been there for them. So that's something that, you know, I think is really cool to hear now. Yeah. And just, you know, learning different ways to do things, you know, and to do a radio show, for instance. Like, even though this is all new to these young people, they still have their own way of doing it.
For sure. Yeah. And I feel like that's part of what makes you a great DJ, is that you're clearly so open to new ways and constantly evolving, and you continue to stay super fresh with all of your music.
I love discovering new music. That's one of my favorite things about being a DJ here, is the constant music discovery. For me, it's just like essential to have fresh new music to listen to all the time.
Yeah. Well, let's get into your song picks.
Let's do it.
Where should we start?
Mumu Fresh is the first song that I picked today. Be Good to You is the track from her brand new record called The Healing that just came out.
Everybody home saying that I'm made. They don't know the pressure on me lately. I can never slip because ain't nobody gonna save me. Going crazy. I watched teary-eyed in amazement. Fall of the pillars that raise me.
Mumu Fresh is a Baltimore-based singer, songwriter, rapper, activist, sound healer. She's of Choctaw, Cherokee, and African-American heritage. She's incredibly talented as a songwriter and a truly gifted singer. And I feel that Mumu Fresh is wildly underrated, in my opinion. She should be a mainstream famous, and I'm hoping that this record gives her a major boost. Mumu Fresh, she's worked with like The Roots, Common, Odyssey, Brandy Younger. You know, I think one of the reasons I gravitate to her music so much is that she reminds me a little bit of like Lauryn Hill, Saw Rock, Rhapsody, even Beyonce.
Yeah, I was going to say, especially this song.
Yeah, this song, and there's another one called Find My Way that also reminds me of Beyonce a bit. Mm-hmm. Definitely has the vocals, though, for sure.
Oh, yeah. I am the obvious choice. Thick like butter, make everything better. Thick like leather, drop me in the wilderness, baby, I'm a setter. I'ma own a place while you still play catcher. Never surrender, never let up. I'm just seeking my center, raising up my two antennas. She did a KEXP in-studio session, I think late last year, that came out just earlier this year. That was so stunning and moving. And the first song, it opens up with just her voice. And that whole song is a cappella, but layering her own voice, harmonizing with herself. And it's just like complete chills. And I think Cheryl, who was hosting the session, put it well when she was like, I'm speechless. And right. That was absolutely magnificent. And for that reason, I urge people to just go listen to it, go experience that. It's on KEXP's YouTube channel.
Much of the new record was produced by DJ Jazzy Jeff and Kitey Tatum and recorded at Jazzy Jeff's Hamptons studio in Delaware. So she's been releasing singles from this album for the last couple of years, and now this is the finished product. And I think this is one of my favorite songs on the record. But there's so many, I had a hard time choosing. What I love about this song is something I think is a bit of a theme throughout the album, and that is the importance of self-care. She says, if you can't save the world, if you can't fix everything, at least be good to you. And I resonate with that so much. Like, something I sometimes find myself telling my loved ones is there's no use stressing over things that are out of your control. And mm-hmm. So I think this song kind of points to that.
Definitely. It's a great anthem for self-care, the deep kind. Let's listen to some more of this song. This is Be Good to You by Mumu Fresh off her recent album, The Healing. He said, why you out saving the world? Who's saving you, girl? Like, who do you run to? Where do you go to have fun to? Who wrote your favorite song you love to make love to? I never thought it could. If you can't see, go up. If you can't mend every broken heart. All right, let's get into your next song. Can you introduce it?
The next song I chose is Tierra Whack, Shower Song. This is from her 2024 album, and it's so hooky.
Yeah. I sound great when I'm singing in the shower. Soap and water give me powers. When I'm singing in the shower.
I really think Tierra Whack is smart because this is like the new Rubber Ducky, in my opinion. Which checks out, actually, because she has been cited crediting Sesame Street as an influence on her music. So I'm on to you, Tierra Whack. But not kidding, though. It's such an easy, like, fun song to remember. And I can't tell you how many times I've sung it in the shower already. Like, it's just awesome. I kind of predict that it will land in some type of advertisement if it hasn't already. Mm-hmm. And I do think it's a bit of a business strategy because she mentions Dove brand in that song.
She does.
And she has previously collaborated with Lego for a cute, youthful music video. Yeah. So I suspect that there's some strategizing there.
Something coming. Yeah, I mean, speaking of the videos, though, her videos are all such a world. There's like very much the Pee Wee Herman kind of vibe. Absurdity and colorfulness and playfulness. And there's like this clown imagery that also plays to that, like, externally maybe or outwardly very playful and silly, but there's also that sad clown inner world that she explores.
Quite the juxtaposition.
Yeah.
But really well done and, like, just incredibly executed. And, you know, I think on the more serious side, like she wrote poetry as a child and is an accomplished spoken word artist too. So it those little tidbits I love learning because you wouldn't necessarily expect that by listening to the music.
Mm-hmm. So this song, Shower Song, from Worldwide Whack.
Yeah, so fun.
So fun. So playful.
Yeah.
It's like a goofy song about singing in the shower and how she sounds so good. She's like talking herself up.
Yep.
It's wonderful. Mm-hmm. It's good self-talk.
It is.
Which I want you to do in the mirror in the morning.
This is funky.
Getting ready for my day. So I gotta get fresh. Gotta exfoliate. You know Dove is the best. I ain't never in a rush.
No.
I perform it like a major.
Yeah.
And I heard my phone ring. But I'll call him back later.
Yeah.
Singing like Whitney. Singing like Britney. Singing like Aretha.
Whoa, whoa.
Singing like Alicia.
Whoa, whoa.
I sound great. When I'm singing in the shower.
Let's get into your third song pick.
Beyoncé. Need I say more? That's it. That's all I got. No. Oh, man. I really love this new album, Cowboy Carter. I chose Texas Hold'em, but again, hard to really choose one song from this record because there's so many good ones.
This ain't Texas. Ooh. Ain't no Hold'em.
Hey.
So lay your cards down, 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 down. So park your Lexus. Your keys up.
Hey.
Stick around, round, 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 round.
You know, I'm a child of the 90s, so I grew up listening to Destiny's Child, and Beyoncé has really yet to do me wrong. Her last two records have been pure gold, in my opinion. I chose this song because, again, it's like one of the catchiest on the album. That and Bodyguard, I feel like, always get stuck in my head, and I just love singing them. But I also kind of love the controversy that seems to be happening when she releases new music lately, because to me, it's just silly. Mm-hmm. You know, I mean, obviously, especially in mainstream music, like there's always going to be, you know, some sort of controversy. Not everybody agrees on music. But and I don't really follow mainstream music news heavily, but the tidbits that I've read or heard just really just make me laugh, because the fact that anyone dares to question Beyoncé's credibility pertaining to a specific genre.
Yeah.
I mean, didn't this happen with her last album too? People were like, why is she trying to make dance music? It's like, are you kidding me? She's not trying. She just did.
She did.
And
yeah.
She did it in her own way. And if she wants to make a country pop album, she should.
Absolutely.
You know? And so, I mean, I could go on for hours about the criticism of art, but I don't think Beyoncé gives a shit what anyone thinks anyways.
She doesn't really need to.
She doesn't have to. She's Beyoncé. I'll be honest, though, if it hadn't been labeled or categorized as country, just hearing the music alone, I don't think I would have recognized it as country pop or, you know, identified it that way. To me, it's just another beautiful Beyoncé record. But if people are mad because they think she's trying to like steal awards in a genre that isn't like quote unquote her lane or something, well, I'd say she earned it, because again, labels are just a construct.
For sure. And I think with both this album and the last one, Renaissance, like there's a pretty clear reclaiming of like the black roots of these of dance music and of country music. And that's an important part of the story too. It's not just brilliant music. It's like she's making a point here.
Exactly.
Here is the one and only Beyoncé with a bit of Texas Hold'em from Cowboy Carter.
There's a tornado,
tornado
in my city,
in my city,
in the basement,
the basement.
That ain't pretty,
ain't pretty.
Rugged whiskey,
we're
surviving.
We survive.
Breakup kisses, sweet redemption, passing time, yeah. Ooh, one step to the right. We headed to the dive bar we always thought was nice. Ooh.
This series is generally focused on new music, but we like to end with a song that's from any era, maybe one that's foundational to you as a DJ. But which song did you pick for that?
I picked Lauryn Hill.
Not and surprised.
Lauryn Hill is probably one of the reasons I love music so much. For me, Lauryn Hill is one of those artists who represents a time in my life when I started discovering music I loved on my own and therefore kind of represents the roots of my taste in like R&B and hip hop music, a genre which gained a lot of traction in the mid 90s. And it's really fun to now hear music by artists like Tierra Whack, create music inspired by Lauryn Hill, Erykah Badu, Missy Elliott, all these musicians that I grew up listening to. And I chose this song because it kind of represents then and now for me, because the songs I liked the most when Miseducation came out were, of course, the songs that were being played on the radio at the time, like doo-wop and Everything is Everything. But now in my adult life with two kids of my own, To Zion, the track I picked, is almost like a new song to me. I'm not sure I could appreciate it the way I do now if I didn't have kids of my own. Mm-hmm. And it just perfectly captures that duality feeling of like the uncertainty of being a new mom and the overwhelming joy that you never imagined possible. Something that I believe in firmly is that if you've never had kids, there's really no such thing as being ready to be a parent.
Yeah.
You're never going to be ready. So yeah, this song makes me emotional. I think it's one of the most beautiful songs ever written.
I agree. Beautifully said too. Let's take a listen to Zion by Lauryn Hill from The Miseducation of Lauryn Hill, 1998.
Unsure what the balance held, I touched my belly overwhelmed by what I had been chosen to perform. But then an angel came one day, told me to kneel down and pray, for unto me a man child would be born. Oh, this crazy circumstance, I knew his life deserved a chance, but everybody told me to be smart. Look at your career, they said, Lauryn, baby, use your head. But instead I chose to use my heart. Now the joy of my world is in Zion.
Thank you so much for sharing those picks. You also had emailed me that you had trouble narrowing it down to three new songs.
Of course.
And you added an honorable mention. And since we have a moment here, do you want to talk about that last song?
Yeah, I appreciate that. Thanks for allowing me to do this, because I think this honorable mention deserves a little nod. It's Macklemore, Hinds Hall, hometown hero.
Yeah,
I think potentially quite literally here, actually, because it's such a timely song. And a really powerful one. So I just want to give props where props are due real quick. Macklemore hit it out of the park with this track. He did what so many artists are or have been afraid to do. And I'd like to think that by him releasing this song, he helped a lot of other artists finally feel empowered to speak out about the ongoing, brutal, unacceptable genocide happening in Palestine. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I witnessed the kind of misguided backlash speaking out about the genocide often leads to just by broadcasting these types of songs on air. And so I thank Macklemore for what he did, because it gives me courage, too. You know, his criticism of the U.S. funding Israel, the conflation of anti-Semitism with anti-Zionism, the calling for a ceasefire of the Israel-Hamas war. He used his platform and privilege for something important, and that deserves praise. And I'm thrilled to hear that the track has been well received.
Thank you for shining a light on this, Ashley, and for often shining a light on music with a message and protest songs like this. It means a lot. And I think that's part of what music is for.
Yeah. The beautiful thing about all these songs I've chosen to share today is that they're great examples of the various different ways in which music can speak to us,
yeah,
like Mumu Fresh, or affect us like Macklemore and Tierra Whack, or shape us like Lauryn Hill. Mm. So, you know, music is definitely a reflection of real life, a timestamp of current affairs, and a solace when you need it most.
Yeah. Well, Macklemore really didn't hold back with this song.
Yes.
Let's take a listen to Hind's Hall from Macklemore. Yeah.
The people, they won't leave. What is threatening about divesting and want a peace? The problem isn't the protests, it's what they're protesting. It goes against what our country is funding. Block the barricade until Palestine is free. Block the barricade until Palestine is free. When I was 7, I learned a lesson from Cuban Eazy-E. What was it again? Oh yeah, f*** the police. Actors and badges protecting property in a system that was designed by white supremacy.
But the people are in the streets. You could pay off Meta, you can't pay off me. Politicians who serve by any means, APAC, Koofy, and all the companies. You see, we sell fear around the land of the free. But this generation here is about to cut the strings. You could ban TikTok, take us out the algorithm, but it's too late. We've seen the truth, we bear witness. Seen the rubble, the buildings, the mothers and the children, and all the men that you murdered. And then we see how you spin it. Who gets the right to defend and who gets the right of resistance? It's always been about dollars and the color of your pigment. But white supremacy is finally on blast, screaming free Palestine to their home at last. We see the lies and claiming it's anti-Semitic to be anti-Zionist. I seen Jewish brothers and sisters out there and writhing in solidarity and screaming free Palestine with them, organizing and learning and finally cutting ties with the state that's gotta rely on apartheid system to uphold and occupy. And violent history been repeating for the last 75. The neck but never ended, the colonizer lied. It's students in tents posted on the lawn, occupying the quad is really against the law, and a reason to call and the police and their squad were to genocide land and your definition.
That was Macklemore with Hind's Call, which features a sample from the great Feroz. That song that sampled is Ana La Habibi.
Ana La Habibi, Habibi Ili, Ya Asfura Bayda, La Baa Tisali, La Ya'tab Hada, Wa La Yizal Hada, Ana La Habibi, Habibi Ili.
Huge thanks to DJ Miss Ashley for sharing these songs with us today. You can listen to Ashley's show live every Sunday from noon to 3 Pacific or anytime in the two-week archive at kexp.org or the KEXP app. If you want to listen to these songs in full, you can find the track list in the description, and you can also follow along on KEXP's Spotify playlist or our YouTube playlist on the KEXP Podcasts YouTube channel. So many platforms, I know. If you lose track, you can always find links on the In Our Headphones podcast page on kexp.org. And as always, we're finishing the episode with one standout song selection from KEXP's music director team. This week, I have Chris Sanley with me. Chris, what song has been playing in your headphones lately?
I cannot stop listening to No Problems by Ginger Root.
Go get what you want. Get hip to the sun and then you. Get lost in your thoughts. Just trying to prove what's with you now and again. I've tried to bow and the bell. The floor and the fake with the lights fade. How can you say this is the debate?
What do you love about this song?
Everything. So, you know those songs that you can't help but like dance, walk to while you're on a stroll? This is totally one of those. I already have it on multiple like walk the dog playlists and can't help but bop along, and like almost caught myself doing finger guns at a neighbor the other day just because I was in the zone and totally vibing out. Ginger Root just has this really cool fusion of alt disco and boogie and soul that's so warm and vibrant with like the woozy synths and guitar riffs, killer bass lines and hooks for days. So this is just, you know, one of those perfect summer pop jams that I keep going back to. So yeah.
The song has a really interesting music video. It starts out with this scene of the artist getting fired from his job at like a production company, then moving on to do his creative work on his own, kind of DIY style. How do you think this ties in with his music?
I love his aesthetic. I love when artists really just show their character so much in the visual accompaniments, and you'd absolutely get that with Ginger Root. And this new album is going to be his third. It's called Shingbangumi, and that'll be out on September 13th. And it's like, it's a concept album. And the way he describes it is, the year is 1987, and Ginger Root has been on contract as a music supervisor for a newly founded television network, Juban TV. That is until he's fired. Blindsided by such an event, Cameron takes matters into his own hands and starts his own media conglomerate, Ginger Root Productions. The question now is, what will they make? And this is our first taste of it, No Problems. And ugh, it's just so good.
What do you think this song is about?
I... I would love to chat with him about what he thinks, you know, the true meaning behind these lyrics are. But for me, I just kind of take it as a look at toxic positivity, where you're just like, you know, you're bopping around with somebody who's just nothing but upbeat and like, mm-hmm. everything's rosy, and you're just like, living in the world today, like, how can you say that you have no problems? You know, like, yeah. there's so much going on, and it's okay to recognize that and acknowledge it and like have a conversation about it. So that's kind of my personal interpretation of the mm-hmm. lyrics.
Even if it's poking fun at toxic positivity a little, I do find the song pretty uplifting and fun and a good one to ease into summertime. Let's listen to some more of No Problem by Ginger Root. Thanks, as always, Chris, for sharing new music with us, and we'll talk to you again next time. That was the song No Problems by Ginger Root, chosen by Chris, KEXP's music director. And before that, I was talking with DJ Ms. Ashley. You can find all the music from this episode on KEXP's In Our Headphones playlist on Spotify. Consider buying the music you love directly from the artists on Bandcamp. And if you enjoy this podcast, please subscribe, rate, and review, or share it with a friend. We'd also love to hear from you. If you have feedback, you can write to us directly at headphones@kexp.org. KEXP is an independent nonprofit radio station, so this podcast, along with all of our programming, is made possible by the generous support of our listeners. If you'd like to support us as well, you can make a donation of $6 a month at kexp.org/headphones. In Our Headphones is hosted and produced by Janice Headley and myself, Isabel Khalili. Audio was mixed by Emily Fox and mastered by William Myers. And our director of editorial is Larry Mizell Jr. Our theme song is How Ma by the band Chinese American Bear. Tune in next week, where Janice will be talking with longtime KEXP DJ Larry Rose. I'm Isabel Khalili. See you next time on In Our Headphones. From listener-powered KEXP, where the music matters.